Hiya folks, so I'm going to get right down to it. These are all of my first round battles for the Underdog Bros 5th Gen Tournament. My first opponent is ChildDaemon, and anyway, leads off with an Archeops and a freaking Audino. I lead off with my Gallade and a Behem, which is subbing in for my Musharna, since they decided not to allow any Dream World abilities, not just the ones that haven't been released yet. In their tournament, they just wanted to simplify things. But anyway, it runs pretty much the same set as Musharna. It's just not quite as slow. Anyway, Mikhail is taken out on the first freaking turn by an Aerial Ace from his Archeops. Archeops is truly, truly a beast, at least until you get it below 50% health. But so anyway, next I send out my Kudzulu. Now this is actually a huge mistake, and I'm really glad it never came up in these rounds. I only just figured this out by watching this. This is the wrong Kudzulu. This is the wrong Tangrowth. This one is a freaking Dreamworld Tangrowth. Again, it doesn't come up at all. But this is my Regenerator Rebreed. I totally screwed that up, and ChildDaemon and my other opponent, watchmegobananas, I'm really sorry about that, but again, it did not matter in either of our battles. I guarantee it. So anyway, I've gotten one KO, and I do a really stupid mistake. I just didn't realize that he'd set up Safeguard, even though I saw him do it. And so my sleep powder is completely and totally blocked. So stupid. And that Safeguard was actually a really cool strategy, because now he's able to boost his Scrafty with Swagger without having to risk the confusion and all that. That Audino is, I'm not even bothering. Oh, I guess I am bothering to attack it. Because I can't attack Scrafty with my Diana. And I can't even use Toxic now. So anyway, my Behem is taken out by a super effective +2 Crunch, and this battle is not going particularly well for me. I'm going to go ahead and send out Lantern, my last Pokemon, and, Lantern's pulled me out of some pretty tight spots. I'm hoping this is going to be one of them. More Helping Hand goodness, and I just know, luckily Kudzulu is slower than his Pokemon. I hit his Barrel with a Power Whip, only does half, which kind of sucks, and I get hit by an Ice Punch, which at +2 is not enough to kill me, because even though I haven't invested anything in Kudzulu's defenses, its defenses are so high to begin with that, it just can take pretty much any hit. Not pretty much any hit, but you know what I'm saying. Anyway, the dimensions return to normal. I'm like, oh geez, this is the end. But actually, Lantern is the fastest Pokemon on the field, which is kind of amazing. So I managed to take down his Scrafty before it can do me any more harm. Unfortunately, now his Swagger has no target but me. I really wish that his Audino had gone first. That would have made things much easier for me. But so now Angler is confused. I don't remember whether it's going to hit itself in the confusion at all. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and Power Whip Cinnamon, and I did manage to take it out. So I think he's now down to his last Pokemon, and I've got two left. So I'm feeling pretty good that I can maybe win this. Anyway, his last Pokemon is a freaking Miss Magius. I hate Miss Magius. And it's going to finish off Kudzulu, no problem. And now it's all up to my Lantern, and it's going to come down to Confusion Hacks, or maybe it won't. But yeah, so I get hit by the Confusion, and that sucks. And so next, he's going to use Energy Ball, but you know what? That's okay, I figure, because Lantern is a special wall. And you see how much it tanks that? I mean, that really wasn't that bad. I snap out of the Confusion this turn. I really wish it had happened the last turn. That would have made my life so much better. Anyway, T-Bolt to the face, not going to be even a two-hit KO, which is rather unfortunate. I get another Energy Ball to the face. I survive with 15 HP, and here's where that Confusion Hacks really hurt me. Had I not gotten confused, I would have gotten 3 T-Bolts off, and I would have won this battle. Que sera, sera. Angler is down, and the battle is over. However, these matches are best of 3, so next we're going to have a rematch. Ooh, look, the screen changed colors. Sorry, I had to download this battle off of WFC because I accidentally deleted the save file where it was saved on. Yeah, I wasn't too smart about that. Okay, but it doesn't matter. I managed to find it, and so here's the battle. he's using the exact same team. I'm switching things up a little bit because, you know, I want to actually win a battle. So yeah, I'm leading off with Kudzulu this time. Although I'm going to call it back based on the fact that he's got Archeops out. And I'm going to go ahead and send out Hatterack, which is going to be able to resist any attack from him, I figure. His rock uses U-turn, but, you know, Behem, like Musharna, although not quite as much as Musharna, is pretty darn bulky, and so it's able to take that hit. Not as well as I would have liked, but it is what it is. So his Cinnamon goes ahead and safeguards, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to set up in the Trick Room this turn. Yeah, I do. So I get up a nice Trick Room, and that's going to be really, really happy. Unfortunately, his Audino has set up the Safeguard, so I am going to have to switch out because it can't really do anything. I send Mikhail back out because I think that's going to be the best counter for Scrafty. Going to be able to hit it with a super effective Drain Punch and whatnot. Anyway, he goes for the Dragon Dance. Kind of stupid to do that in a Trick Room situation, but I guess he wanted the attack boost. Anyway, I go ahead and use Dragon Tail to get him out. That was actually really stupid. I mean, if I was bringing out Mikhail specifically to counter it, but whatever. Okay, so unfortunately, his Cinnamon also has Trick Room, and freaking returns the dimensions back to normal. Stupid Audino. Anyway, it goes ahead and Helping Hands his Miss Magius, who I know is going to be an offensive beast. I'm going to go ahead and Shadow Sneak it, hoping to kill. It does over half, but not enough to kill, and so that's sad pandas for me. And with the Helping Hand, I am not at all surprised that this is a one-hit KO. Mikhail goes down and just really didn't get to do much in this pair of battles. Hyderach goes ahead and uses Rock Slide. His Luna avoids the attack, which sucks because that's who I really wanted to hit. And yeah, I pop Aldino's air balloon. Big freaking whoop. Anyway, Kudzulu is back out. Not sure that I have much other choice. Another Helping Hand. His Luna goes for a Hidden Power. Let's see if I can determine the type. Anyway, it hits Steelix for super effective damage. So probably Hidden Power Fire, maybe Fighting? Most likely Fighting. I mean, come on. Ghost types love Hidden Power Fighting. Anyway, I don't know why I'm using... Well, Rock Slide is actually going to be able to hit both of his Pokemon. And I don't want, you know, to use Earthquake because Kudzulu wouldn't like that. Anyway, so yeah. Another Hidden Power Fighting is going to be enough to take out Hatterack. And this battle is looking worse than the last one. But yeah, Kudzulu goes ahead and uses Knock Off. Okay, so this is the one difference. My other Kudzulu, the one that isn't Regenerator, doesn't run Knock Off. It runs... Come on, I know this. Come on. The attack is called... Oh, no, Synthesis. Anyway, but it doesn't matter because I could have used a Hidden Power there and it would have delivered the KO at that amount. It's Hidden Power Ice. So it would have been fine. But so anyway, yeah. Again, really sorry about that, ChildDaemon and Watch Me Go Bananas. But I swear to God, it did not matter in our battles. Anyway, yeah, of course. Aerial Ace is going to one-hit KO Kudzulu because, you know, super effective and super-duper powerful. And I don't know why I just used Recovery here. I should have gone for the Trick Room, if anything. Although he has Trick Room. Maybe he thought I'd use Trick Room and it would balance out. I don't know. But anyway, this is going to be the end of the battle. Another Helping Hand here, and his Rock uses U-Turn. I don't think that's going to kill me. Unless it's a crit. Yeah, it's super effective. Oh, and he had Helping Hand. That's right. Okay, just kidding. So anyway, lost to ChildDaemon 0-2, and so that stinks. But now I'm on to my next opponent, eventually. Who is Watch Me Go Bananas transition? There we go. Okay. Yeah, so Watch Me Go Bananas is my next opponent in the tournament. And he leads off with Archeops again. What is Archeops, like the mascot for this tournament? And freaking Cresselia. I know I'm all like, about all these Pokemon, but I hate Cresselia. It really annoys me. It's hard to kill and whatnot. Anyway, Archeops goes for the Earthquake, hits my team, but, you know, they survive. You know, Steelix is pretty darn defensive, and as is Bayahim. Anyway, gets the freeze, and I'm like, oh man, are you serious? That sucks so bad! Go for the Rock Slide here, and I believe I get... Yeah, so that's going to be enough to bring Archeops down to half health. And so, yeah, okay, I de-thaw on this turn, so hacks meets hacks, and the end result is, you know, it's all good. And so, yeah, so I got out, get out the Trick Room. Hatterack is now faster than, or is going to go before anyone else who doesn't have priority, and I've taken down his freaking Archeops, even though it really wasn't a threat to me at this point with what its attack had. Anyway, Diana recovers its HP with Recover, appropriately named. He sends out Kit Kat, his Espeon, and Hatterack's going to go ahead and use Earthquake, even though his I Have a Face is in the air. So really all it's doing is hitting Espeon, but it's still going to do a good amount of damage. Anyway, Diana goes ahead and uses Toxic, because that's really the best way to kill a Cresselia. As long as it's not running Heal Bell, I'm pretty sure it can run Heal Bell, but maybe I'm wrong. But anyway, yeah, that's really the best way to kill a Cresselia in my experience. I mean, I guess, you know, Exeter? I don't know if you have someone to use it. Anyway... Diana is down to pretty low HP, but it's actually taking those hits, tanking those hits pretty well, so that's kind of cool. Hatterack goes ahead and Rock Slides. I'm just hoping for the flinch hacks, basically. It's not really doing much damage. Yeah, Steelix doesn't really have the best of attack, and I can understand the people who don't like using it because of that reason, but I don't know, it's always worked out pretty well for me. Anyway, Espeon's Shadow Ball, I think, is going to take out, yeah, it does take out Diana on this turn. Bye-bye, Bayahim. I don't remember whether I brought Mikhail, my Gallade in this match, so I'm not sure whether once the Trick Room runs out that's going to be it. Yeah, I guess, so my next Pokemon is Tachikoma, my Rotom Frost form, which, you know, thanks to the fact that Steelix is Ground-type, I'm going to be able to use discharges with impunity, if I so desire. And indeed I do go discharge, although Blizzard would probably have been the better move since it does more damage. And it also gets stabbed. That's the great thing about Rotom, the new Rotom form, so they now have the secondary typing. Although, you know, I can understand the criticism, well, you've ruined a perfectly good spin blocker. But then again, you know, what's his name? Blanking on the name. Jellicent is, you know, taking on Rotom's role as a spin blocker, at least I think so. Anyway, while I've been just blabbing on, I think my opponent made a mistake not realizing about the, you know, type change, because, you know, probably thought that Shadow Ball would be super effective and thought that Ice Beam would be regularly effective. Instead, Shadow Ball is just regularly effective and Ice Beam is, resisted, and so, yeah. So, anyway, I still haven't taken out any of his Pokemon, although I Have a Face succumbs to the poison, so that's nice. Yeah, just his Pokemon have been really bulky. I mean, I guess I took down one Pokemon a little earlier. So, anyway, yeah, Shadow Ball takes down Tachikoma, and how do I use Gyro Ball? Oh, yeah, taking down two of his Pokemon. I'm not paying attention. Anyway, I've just won the match, but again, they're best of two. So I've got one more battle, and a little bit, yeah, okay, here we go. Final battle is going to be, you know, I think I switched up my team a little bit, and so did he. Diana and Tachikoma are going to lead, and he sends out Quagsire along with his Archeops. Quagsire. At least I know it's not unaware, although, you know, I don't have any boosting Pokemon this time around. Yeah, so get the defense drop with the crunch. Tachikoma goes for the Blizzard, which is going to be super effective against Archeops and regularly effective against Quagsire, but it gets a crit on his Quagsire, so I'm really sorry about that. This has kind of been a hexy few battles, although the point of having the best of three is supposed to be that, you know, the hex isn't supposed to matter as much. I don't know, your mileage may vary what you think. I do get the Trick Room up. Diana survived with 90 HP, so that's all good. Out comes that freaking Cresselia again, and now I see another new Pokemon, Infernape, Unfortunately, not a good Pokemon to bring to this battle because I have the Psychic, and that's going to be an easy KO. I think Beheem has more special attack than, whatchamacallit, than Musharna, so that's one nice thing about this. But so, yeah, Discharge here. I don't know why I used Discharge. That was kind of silly. But anyway, I should have used Blizzard since, you know, it's really not doing too much. Go for the Toxic, because again, that's going to be the best way to kill Cresselia. I've poisoned him, going for the Blizzard now, and, you know, yeah, Blizzards miss sometimes, but it has a hell of a lot of power. Recover some HP with Heal Bell, and, you know, this is his last Pokemon. I have all four of mine, so this battle is pretty much in the bag, or so I figure. Diana goes ahead and recovers. You know, it's just basically in here to stall him out. Maybe kind of a lame strategy, but it is what it is. Gonna go ahead and go for the Blizzard again. Now, Blizzard misses this time. He goes for an Ice Beam. It's gonna hit, but, you know, isn't doing too much damage because I've got great special defense. So I keep on recovering and, you know, just waiting for the clock to run out. Waiting for the poison damage to just keep racking up, or, you know, for me to get a nice blizzard to the face. So here comes the blizzard to the face, as I was saying. I have a face down low enough that on the next turn, on this turn, at the end of this turn, the poison damage is going to finish the battle. So, good game, Watch Me Go Bananas. Also, good game, ChildDaemon. See you in the rest of the tournament. Bye.